So hey guys, so in this video I'm going to be talking to you guys or just showing you my portfolio that I submitted to UAL. I'm currently studying at Camberwell and I'm about to graduate in 3 months. So this is kind of overdue, but also by the end of the video I'll actually share and what the uni experience has been like. So yeah, without further ado, let's just get into it. So I'm recording screen recording my portfolio that I had submitted, because I obviously don't have all the pieces that I made, but I also made some videos, so I'm gonna go backwards. There are 38 pieces that I submitted. I think they had a limit of 38, so I made sure that I sort of showed them my entire set of skills that I had, but also the variety of things that I was working on. And I took 2 gap years, so that sort of really helped me build my portfolio. So apart from just submitting all the work that I submitted for my A-levels, I was able to do other work while on my gap year, and I decided to put that in as well. So the first is just like this sort of mural piece that I worked on. Now I'm not gonna share the entire video because it's gonna take forever, but he's just like a short clip of it, you know. So just like the entire process of it, and like this is what I was working on. This is also sort of makes sense. I was working in this was actually a commission, so it's not like my work, but so this was the first one. The other video that I submitted was more of an art piece that I did. This is on my YouTube, so you can watch the entire thing. And this was, you can see I was a lot more good looking back then. I'm gaining some weight, but this is in 2019, and it was about me figuring out a way to sort of mix up my interest in art and dance and music, and also sort of recording the process and making a piece out of the recording of the process. This is again on my YouTube, so you can find it. I'll link it up over here or something. Again, this was another piece that I did in 2016. This is also on my YouTube, so you can find the entire process of it here. And I think it was interesting sending them this up instead of just sending them, you know, the picture of the piece. This is just a still life I did. This was for my A-levels again. This was part of the 5-page portfolio. This is the painting that I made for the art video that I just shared. I'm gonna skim through some of these, but I think sharing with them what sort of things I was thinking about, rather than, oh, this is how I paint or this is how well I paint, was, I think, valuable to them. Because I remember having a conversation during my interview about this exact same thing. This is just, I think, this is a picture of my sketchbook and some digital pieces. So I think because we had to submit 38 images, I think the maximum limit was 38. I decided, okay, there's more that I need to show. So if I can just show them more rougher images of things that I make on the side, or just things that sort of show them that I think, not just through making final pieces. Sometimes they can just be like, oh, images. So images of my sketchbook, so it was stuff like this. This is a piece that I was supposed to submit for my A-levels. Then I had a lot of self-referencing or like portraits in my work. I do not look like this anymore. I don't think I looked like this at the time. My forehead is too big in this. This is just a digital piece that I made in 2018, so I submitted this as well. This is not part of my portfolio, but it was still building on some themes that I was exploring in my work during A-levels. This is again sketchbooks. I'm gonna skim through these super fast, you know, just showing them the process. This is, I think, my A-level sketchbook. Yeah, this is my A-level sketchbook. So yeah, again, this is, you know, sketches, ideas, planning of pieces, you know, and some practice. I used to be really conflicted about filmmaking and stuff like that, if I wanted to pursue that or go into the arts or fine art. Super glad I did the latter. Again, planning of pieces, and you will see these pieces later on, I think, you know, inspiration. This is like very typical A-level GCSE sketchbook. Not too proud of it, not too glad about it. Again, planning of some paintings, like images that were coming in my head, just make them. Sketchbook again, like, this is typical like A-level work, a GCSE work, where you're just, if you don't have anything specifically that you're exploring, your tutors will tell you just like make work about yourself. And the easiest way to sort of make work about yourself is to make yourself a lot, which is good. It helps you explore what you sort of care about and explore different styles while remaining. So yeah, during my gap year, I was working with my friends, and we were just making these random murals around Karachi, the city I'm from. And I thought, you know what, I'm pretty sure this, even though like in terms of the quality of the work or like the craft of it, we weren't that amazing, but I thought, okay, this would be really cool to put in, because this is something I worked on, and this will sort of show them other sort of mediums or forms or ways that I'm trying to practice the existing skills that I have. So this is showing like collaboration, this is showing, okay, thinking about work in public spaces and stuff like that. This is just a piece that I made digitally on Photoshop, I think, about the collective that we had. This is an acrylic piece, again, typical A-level work. This is, again, a piece that I made. I think I digitally edited the piece. I was photographing these buses in Karachi, and then I think it was on aquarelle. So yeah, the rest is just watercolors. Acrylic piece, self-referencing. So you can see the quality of the work. In retrospect, like, again, there were a lot of things I could improve on, but that's just the level I was at back then. I'm probably still at the same level. Yeah, so again, I think if you're not from the UK, I think it's great if you can submit work that also sort of shows your cultural background. That's what you're also sort of encouraged to do for the GCSEs, and why shouldn't you? Because like, if you're trying to be something that you aren't and it's not of your background or culture, then it's sort of going to be less authentic. So this was another piece that was still exploring stuff. So this was in acrylics. Most of these pieces are like A1 sizes. So this was, again, I showed the planning of the piece, and then I also have the piece. So I'll just show that to you guys again. It was here. So I was experimenting with like gold spray paint and stuff like that on inks and stuff, and inks. So I decided to put that in. And this was one of the pieces that I made. I was 18 at the time, I'm 24 now. So it's been a while. So this is a piece that I made. Again, it has Urdu in it. It's interesting, I'm using Urdu again in my work, just realized. So I think I just thought that there are so many videos like these that exist on YouTube, but they're like of these students and people, and they're sort of presented in this super ultra perfect way. And I've seen so many of those, and I thought, you know, somebody who didn't do that amazingly during GCSEs could share their work. I did get like an A in my 10-page portfolio, but I got like a D in my 5-page portfolio. I didn't actually have a final piece. So overall, I got a C. Again, similar work that I was exploring. So this was definitely from my 10-page portfolio. This is watercolors and acrylics. Really proud of this piece, actually worked hard on it. Entirely watercolors. Made a lot of detailed. I really enjoyed working with watercolors back then. Haven't worked with them so far, but I would love the fact that I actually had a decent amount of control with them if I was patient. And this was my final piece, and it's not opening up great. Photos. So yeah, this was my final piece that I made for my 10-page portfolio. This is entirely in watercolors. I think I call it the journey is the destination or something deep like that. I was trying really hard. But yeah, this was an A1. But in retrospect, I'm really glad I worked super, super hard on this piece. And I think the last one is this piece, which was again, I think I wanted to send them a photo of the mural, but then I thought, okay, it would be better if I just send one image that sort of shows that it was a collaboration, it was multiple people working on it, and just three images showing before and after. And I think if you think that is going to be valuable for your submission, try doing that. I think I want to sort of get to the part in the video where I thought about saying that if you're watching this video and I asked you to like stick to the end, that is, you know, you do not need to get into UL or Camberwell or any sort of high ranking university to make progress creatively. I did not get into Parsons. I did not get into a lot of universities. I was gonna go to Paris College of Art, but then my visa application didn't follow through. And I think I got really, really lucky, but that's a story for another time. But all I'm saying is that you're gonna see so many of these videos online, and they're gonna be presented by these people who are like amazing on camera. They're amazing in the way they speak about their work, and they seem very, very assured, and it can make you feel like that you haven't done enough or achieved enough. And I just want you to know that these things do not determine your creative success necessarily. But also, you know, I had a C in my A-level art, GCSE art, and yet I was able to get in. So regardless of whether you get in or not, I'd say like apply, work hard, make an effort to get in. But if you don't, it's all right. You know, doing art uni during the pandemic was such a waste of time and energy. My second year was entirely in my room, and I missed a lot of opportunity to make the work I wanted to. But I think that's about it. Here's where I'll end the video. And if you're applying, good luck. Regardless of whether you get in, something will come along and something good will happen. And if it's not, I'm being too philosophical right now, low on energy. But anyways, life is enjoy. Consider subscribing. It's free. You can always unsubscribe later. Peace.